Welcome to a tutorial on the course format for both the Arithmetic Pre-Algebra MOOC and the Introductory Algebra MOOC sponsored by Phoenix College. In this tutorial, you'll become familiar with the course components as well as how to navigate the course efficiently. If you're looking for general information about the two MOOCs, you should visit phoenixcollege.edu/MOOC. Here you'll find general information about the two MOOCs, registration directions, and a course syllabus for each course. So this video assumes that you've already registered for one of the two courses. I thought we should start with a definition of what a MOOC is. MOOC stands for a massive open online course, which is an online course aimed at large-scale interactive participation and open access using the web. You always log into the course at math.pc.maricopa.edu. Before logging in, we want to select Force Image-Based Display. Let's go to the site. Notice how at the bottom you will find registration directions as well as links to additional information about the MOOCs here on the left. But the login is on the top right, so let's log in with the username and password. Select this third option, Forced Image Based Math, and click Login. The course you're registered for will appear here on the left. Again, both course formats are the same. So for this tutorial, I'll use the Arithmetic Pre-Algebra MOOC. So we click the link, and we're in the course. This is the course homepage. The first thing you'll probably notice is the calendar. If I change the number of weeks to 8 weeks, you'll get a nice view of the due dates for the next several weeks. If we click on a particular day, let's say October 2nd, a list appears below, giving specifically what assignments are due, as well as providing links to the work. Notice every assignment is due at 11:59 p.m. Below the calendar are the announcements, which you should always check once logging in. This is the main way that I'll communicate with you throughout the semester. I'll also include the due dates in red. Now let's talk about accessing the course content. Let's close the announcements by clicking on the announcements again. The course is organized similar to how a textbook is organized. Each module folder is like a chapter, then within each module folder you will find module sections. So if we click on Module 1 folder, notice how Module 1 has 8 sections. At the top, we have a link to Chapter 1 ebook, as well as the solutions to the odd problems. If we enter Section 1.1, we'll find 3 subsections, and every section is exactly the same. The first subsection is a link to the section ebook. This is a PDF file that can be downloaded, saved, or printed. Next, we have the video assignments. For these, you're required to watch the video. Welcome to a lesson on place value and whole numbers. You can watch it in full screen by clicking here. Once you watch the video, you click this box verifying you've watched the video, then click Submit to receive your points. After reading the text and completing the video assignments, you're ready for the third subsection, which is the homework assignment. If you need help to complete a question, most of the questions do have a video link here to provide help. These videos are not the same as the video lessons. In this problem, we're given the number 53,981,476. You also have the option to jump to the answer, which may refresh your memory on how to complete the problem. If we do click jump to answer, though, it will warn us that to get credit, we'll have to work a new version. So here it gives the answers to this question, but to get credit, we'll have to try a similar question. The other way to get help would be to click on this link here that says post this question to forum. This posts this question to the Math Lounge, which is where students can help students, but I also monitor the Math Lounge. So I click on this link within the question. It copies the current homework question into the discussion board, and then you can ask a question. Click Submit and wait for someone to respond. Now let's go back, close the section. Notice after all the module sections, there's a practice test which is your best study guide to do well on the test, and a link to the actual test. Now, if we go back to the home page, you can also access the video assignments, homework, and test from the calendar. So if I click on October 6th, these are all active links for the work that is due that night. Now let's talk about communication. You can send me a message from the internal messaging system by clicking on the message link here on the top or on the side. If you click Send New Message, I will be the default recipient. Let's go back. You can also post questions in the Math Lounge discussion forum under the Discussion Forums tab. Click on Math Lounge. Click Add New Thread. You can ask homework questions here or general questions about the course. Again, let's go back. And now let's talk about monitoring your progress. You can always monitor your progress in the course by viewing the online gradebook, which again, there's a link here on the top or on the left. If we scroll all the way to the bottom, there are two columns. There will be a past due grade and a past due and attempted grade. You should mainly be concerned about your past due grade, which is your grade based upon the work in which the due date has passed. The past due and attempted grade also includes the work you've worked on or if you're working ahead. So if you take a test early and want to know how it affects your grade, you would look under past due and attempted. So these are the main components of the two MOOCs. Let's review what we just covered. As you get started each day, you always want to check the course calendar for the due dates, as well as read the announcements for important information. To access the course content, you enter a module folder and then a module section. You'll find links to the ebook, video lessons, and homework assignments. You can also access the coursework through the course calendar by clicking on a day to access the video and homework assignments. For communication, you can use the messaging system as well as the Math Lounge discussion forum, or use a discussion forum link within each homework question. To monitor your progress, use the online gradebook, where you'll find your past due grade as well as your past due and attempted grade. I look forward to working with you. If you have any questions, please let me know.